With me on Skype this morning from Shield Therapeutics, I'm joined by Tim Watts. Tim, good morning.
Morning, Andrew.
You've had a six-month update. I suppose one of the big events happened post-period with the FDA approval, which has been well documented for Feraccru. But the 6 months itself here, a period of solid progress for you. Just tell me a bit more about it.
Yes, it's been a fairly successful six-month period. We've had good operational results in that Norgine have now started to promote Feraccru in Europe, and they've had a good six-month run at that now, essentially in Germany and England, and we can touch on that again in a moment, I guess. But also we've had interesting and good clinical study results from our head-to-head study where we put Feraccru up against Injectafer, which was the leading intravenous iron product. And we also have the long-term results from the chronic kidney disease study, which were very promising and very good as well. So interesting from a commercial point of view, we got going in Europe and good clinical study results. But as you say, the really big talking point has been the US approval.
You mentioned the positive results there from that head-to-head study. That, of course, triggered a milestone payment too, didn't it?
It did. And so under our agreement with Norgine, they undertook to pay us €2.5 million in the event of successful outcome for the head-to-head study. So our revenues for the first 6 months of the year were dominated really by that payment. In total, we got £2.6 million in revenue in the first 6 months. 2.2 of that is the €2.5 million payment that we got. So that clearly dominated the revenue piece, but obviously it was good to get it in.
And so you're encouraged, despite it being relatively early days, you're encouraged by the sales in Europe and how that's progressing?
We are. We have seen, in fact, we said in the RNS that the in-market sales of packs in the UK and Germany for the second quarter of 2019 was almost 60% ahead of the same figure for the fourth quarter of 2018. So we are very encouraged by that, that pickup of sales. And it's important to recognise that although we say we have launched in the UK, the reality is that in the product is not yet reimbursed in Scotland, in Wales and in Northern Ireland. And indeed, in many of the clinical commissioning groups across the UK, it is not yet reimbursed. Hmm. So we're really still operating in a subset of England, or at least Norgine operating in a subset of England. So the fact that those sales are up 60% is encouraging.
And what about Switzerland?
Switzerland, it's not on the market yet, but we got a small 0.1 million milestone from our partner there, Ewo, because the Swiss authorities extended the indication for which Feraccru can be used from the original, it was allowed to be treated for iron deficiency anemia patients who are suffering from inflammatory bowel disease, but the authorities extended that to all iron deficiency in adults, so which is the same as we have in the European Union. So obviously, that's very pleasing for Switzerland, and Ewo are now applying for a pricing and reimbursement in Switzerland.
And when might it hit the market there?
Not sure. I think possibly next year.
Right. But I suppose all eyes now on the potential for the US market.
Exactly. So we now have the product approved in the US as of 2 weeks ago. It's going to be called Acrifer in the US. We have started a process to find a commercial partner in the US, and perhaps inevitably, having had the approval come through, we have, and the advisor firm that we're working with, have shaken the tree to see if there's any further interest. We have had quite a lot of interest anyway to date. So we now need to work on the interest that we've seen and to narrow the field down to companies who we believe are seriously interested, who have the right credentials to take on the product on our behalf, and who are offering the sort of financial terms that we would want to accept. But the process is underway, and as I said earlier, we believe that we can get it done, get it completed by the end of this year.
And of course, the US, that's the big focus for you. But discussions ongoing as far as partners where China's concerned?
And in China too, we have a short list of potential partners that we've identified there, and that process is proceeding as well. So again, we think it's a reasonable target to shoot for to have that deal done by the end of 2019.
And how's the cash at Shield at the moment?
Well, the cash that we have, excluding any upfronts that we might get from either of those two deals, the cash that we have at the moment would last us doing the things that we want to do until the third quarter of 2020. But we our optimism that we will get a US or a Chinese deal is such that we believe that we will get sufficient cash in from those one of those deals or both of those deals to last us through for much longer than the Q3 2020. But right now, Q3 2020 is the runway.
And so in your view, Shield Therapeutics in pretty good shape at the moment, financially?
It's in solid shape. I mean, clearly, if you had the money in the bank, it would be great. But if you consider where we've been over the last 12 months, we're in a far, far stronger position now than we were a year ago. And with the US approval, we are in a good place. We have to convert that into a deal, but then we believe we have every prospect of doing that. The approval in the US is great. The label is for the treatment of iron deficiency in adults, so that is a broad label. That means it should be extremely attractive to a significant number of partners. So it gives us a great deal of confidence that we can get a deal done.
Good to see you, Tim. Thanks very much.
Andrew, thanks for your time.